am Dr. Anand Kumar, surgical gastroenterologist from Ananya Gastroenterology. Today we would discuss about the most common problems faced by the younger generation, especially software group, I would say, those who are sedentary and sitting and constipated people in the world are younger generation. They are called piles or fissures. It is very common to see nowadays, probably in my 20-25 years of surgical practice, I never used to see piles and fissures as common as I see today. So why we are getting piles or fissures? First and foremost thing, for the reason for piles and fissures are, one is hereditary. If your parents are having piles or fissures, it is common to have one of the kith and kin can develop piles and fissures. The second most common cause is constipation, hard stools, unattended natural calls, neglected natural calls, and eating what we call it as continental kind of food, where we eat only cheesy material or burger kind of things or some kind of non-fiber diet. So this can lead to constipation, and definitely these people at some point of time they will develop either piles or fissures. These two are definitely different. Most of the patients who come to me by seeing a physician or a gynecologist, especially in ladies, they come and say, "Doctor, I have piles." I always ask, so basically you don't declare what you have, because you are not a doctor, you are not a surgeon. See, once I listen to their symptoms, like if the patient has piles or hemorrhoids, they usually don't have pain. Usually they say, whenever I pass stools, at the end, when I completely pass stools, suddenly I see there is a gush of blood, or I see drops of blood coming, fresh blood after the stools. So, and if I ask them, do they have pain? They say, "No, sir, I never had pain." Suddenly I see the whole pan is full of blood, and I get scared, where I have cancer. So this is piles. Whereas fissure, patient always say, "Doctor, I am so scared to go to the loo because it really pains." Whenever patient passes hard stools, whatever, we have what is called two kind of sphincters. One is internal sphincter, other is external sphincter. Internal is controlled by internal mechanism, what is called as autonomic nervous system. The external sphincter is controlled by us. It is called a voluntary sphincter. There is a lot of difference. So the main culprit in fissure is internal sphincter. Internal sphincter does not listen to you. When you have to pass hard stool, you put lot of pressure, that time suddenly the internal sphincter releases and there will be a cut in the mucosa and skin junction. So it causes severe pain. People always say, "I see stars, doctor." Some people say, "I fell down with giddiness." And after that, I find some amount of bleeding in some cases. So these are fissures. Absolutely, you can make out by yourself saying that whether you have piles or fissures. And some people say, "Whenever I wash, I feel there is a swelling around the anal canal. There is some kind of projection, doctor, I feel that is a tumor." So it is usually common. Sometimes if you have grade 3 piles or grade 2 piles, when you sit for in the toilet, you can feel them projecting out. Or there is a skin enlarged in case of fissure, causing what we call it as external skin tag, or we call it as external hemorrhoids. They are not piles. For all practical purpose, we don't call them as piles. They are skin projections, hypertrophied skin. Then, doctor, what can I do to prevent these piles? See, once you come to a doctor, you have piles. Most of the times you come at the stage of where either you have grade 2 or grade 3. Grade 1 patient will never come to us until unless they have gone for something else and somebody has done colonoscopy and they say, "Oh, you have grade 1 piles." And fissure patient usually come to you only, to a surgeon only, when it is chronic fissure, not when it is acute fissure. I can treat acute fissure and grade 1, 2 hemorrhoids with medical treatment only. The medical treatment is is there within yourself, within your home. We call it as lifestyle modification. Whenever people have constipation, you prevent constipation, your piles in grade 1 will usually stay there, they don't progress. In case of fissure also, if you have smooth stools, you take fiber food, you take sprouts, you take lot of liquids, you take a precaution to see that you attend your natural cause as and when you get that feel, then you will not have these problems. They are preventable diseases. But when you have chronic fissure which recurrently comes and troubles, you say, 1 week I was all right, sir, then it is healed. After a month, it is coming back. Now I am unable to sit, I am unable to work, I have bleeding, I cannot even have food. Those patients require it definitely. There is something called a surgical treatment. There are two kinds of treatments for fissure. One is dilatation, one is sphincterotomy. Acute fissures, we usually give some kind of botulinum injection, which is as good as surgery. We inject there the botulinum injection. They usually respond, but this is to heal the fissure, but not to cure your this one. The cure is purely dependent on your lifestyle modification. Okay, if I operate for a sphincterotomy, if I do a sphincterotomy for fissure, doesn't mean that you will not develop piles later. Because once I release the internal sphincter mechanism, sometimes you tend to have constipation, you may not have fissure, you tend to put pressure, usually you develop secondary piles. So, the lifestyle modification is the answer for management of piles and fissures. And if you have grade 2 and 3 for hemorrhoids, we have latest technique called stapler hemorrhoidectomy, which is less painful than open hemorrhoidectomy. If they are grade 3 and bigger, we usually go for open hemorrhoidectomy. It is all decided by the kind of piles you have and the grade of piles. If all the three piles, 7 o'clock, 11 o'clock and 3 o'clock position piles, all have same size, that means grade 2, we will do stapler. If they are uneven, we will do open surgery. If there is a fissure, we will do sphincterotomy. But after this, all this treatment, I always tell them, strict advice, take care of your diet. The most thing is, think of eating organic food, natural food, lot of fruits in your night meal, fiber food, sprouts, or any kind of food which has lot of fiber. People always come and say, I would like to eat oats, there is lot of fiber. I don't say a particular kind of food, but any food which has fiber. The only thing is, like green leafy vegetables, keera, carrot, sprouts, which you need not go and buy anywhere, you can prepare at home, because you can cure all these things, you can prevent all these things by just change of your lifestyle. Thank you.